अबाउट फूड न्यूट्रिशन एंड लाइवलीहुड सिक्योरिटी. इकोनॉमी पब्लिक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन सिस्टम हाईलाइट्स द डिफरेंट डायमेंशंस ऑफ द फूड सिक्योरिटी प्रॉब्लम इन कंटेक्स्ट ऑफ द करंट नेशनल लॉकडाउन टू टैकल द COVID-19 पैंडमिक हैज़ highlighted the problems of food nutrition and livelihood security confronting a large number of rural people in particular migrants to cities measures taken are provisions such as by giving of additional rice or wheat some pulses and oil free of cost as well as 1000 rupees cash for the purchase of other essential commodities through the public distribution system dimensions in food security Availability of food in the market. The first is the availability of food in the market, and this is seen as a function of production. Because of Green Revolution, today we have enough food in the market and in government godowns. This is a great accomplishment by Indian farmers who converted a ship-to-mouth situation to a right-to-food commitment. Yet we cannot take farmers' contribution in terms of sustaining production for granted. While some special exemptions have been given to the agricultural sector, farmers are confronted at the moment with labor shortages. Many of the inputs, including seeds, are expensive or unavailable. Marketing arrangements, including supply chains, are not fully functional. Pricing is not remunerative, and public procurement is also not adequate. There is no room for complacency, as in the absence of demand, the lack of storage or value addition facilities, especially for perishable commodities. We do not yet know exactly what the impact of the current pandemic will be on the kharif sowing and food availability in the future. Widen the food basket. The second dimension is the access of food, which is a function of purchasing power. As unless you are a farmer and grow your own food, others have to buy it. The government, though the National Food Security Act and the PDS, has assured some additional food to every individual during this crisis. This should be further strengthened and the food basket widened by including millets, pulses and oil. Steps should be taken to avoid hidden hunger caused by the deficiency of micronutrients in the diet. In light of the closure of schools and Anganwadi centers and the consequent disruptions in the provisions of midday meals or other nutritional inputs, it is important to pay attention to the life cycle approach advocated in the NFSA, particularly the first 1000 days in a child's life, when the cognitive abilities of the child are shaped. We may otherwise see negative effects on nutritional security in the medium or longer term. Nutritious and good quality of food. Food security and access to nutritious, good quality food is also contingent on job security. Today, a lot of people employed both on farms and in the non-farm sector are without jobs. If job security is threatened, then so is food and nutrition security. We have to ensure people do not lose their jobs, and one way of doing this will be to ensure value addition to primary products. An example of such value addition is the rice biopark in Myanmar, wherein the straw, bran and the entire biomass are utilized. This would of course mean some attention to and investment in new technologies that can contribute to biomass utilization. The Amul model provides a good example from the dairy sector of improved incomes to milk producers through value addition. Similar attention needs to be given to the horticulture sector on a priority basis. Women farmers are at the forefront of horticulture, and special attention needs to be given to both their technological and economic empowerment during this crisis. Work under MNREGA to livelihood security for small and marginal farmers and landless households and women within them is strengthening the Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, that is MNREGA. The definition of a worker in MGNREGA has so far been applied only to unskilled manual work and not to skilled jobs in agriculture and allied activities. Given the lack of jobs and income during the COVID-19 crisis, it is imperative to expand the definition of work in MGNREGA to cover skilled work related to farmers and their farming activities. This is particularly important for women farmers and workers who should not just be given task of carrying stones and digging mud. Apart from farming, they engage in a range of essential care tasks, including caring for children, the elderly, and sick people. These tasks, often invisible, need to be recognized as work and supported with appropriate education, including on nutrition. Focus on non-food factors. The third dimension of food security is absorption of food in the body or its utilization, which is dependent, importantly, on sanitation, drinking water, and other non-food factors, including public health services. Ensuring that these services are functional depends on the capabilities of the local panchayats and their coordination with other local bodies. The lack of adequate clean water in particular has come to the fore in both rural areas and urban slums in the context of COVID-19, where one of the key measures for stopping transmission relates to frequent hand washing. Way ahead. If we can ensure food availability, food access, and food absorption, then we have a fairly robust system of food and nutrition security. All the above dimensions are, however, now threatened by the novel coronavirus, as discussed earlier. It is very critical to highlight the linkages between agriculture, nutrition, and health. While the PDS may be able to meet calorie needs, the inability to harvest, transport, and market perishable fruits and vegetables at remunerative prices during the current crisis has not just deprived farmers of incomes and livelihoods, but consumers too are deprived of micronutrients and their diets. Farmers are making losses and agriculture moving from being job-led to jobless raise questions about the sustainability of the production cycle. At the same time, this can have long-term consequences on nutrition and health security. So the conclusion is, today's problems are not as daunting. Though a combination of farmers' cooperation, technological upgrading, and favorable public policies in procurement, pricing, and distribution, we can deal with the fallouts of the pandemic. We hope that this pandemic will help recognize the contribution of our farmers. With reference to the Chitra acryl soap secretion solidification system, consider the following statements. So, it is highly efficient, super absorbent material for liquid respiratory and other body fluid solidification and disinfection for the safe management of infected respiratory secretion. Acryl soap can absorb liquids at least 20 times more than its dry weight and also contains a decontaminant for in situ disinfection. Question is, what are the dimensions of reforms that urgently required in the Indian agriculture sector to deal with the pandemic?